Welcome to Video Lowell, a news program created by Lowell students for Lowell students. I'm your host, Charlotte Wu.
And I'm your other host, Yenna Im. Let's see what's been going up at Lowell these past few months, shall we? That was awesome. Give it up for our editors.
Senior Boat is coming up on November 12th. And believe it or not, it will be happening on a boat.
Yes, it will be moving. So be prepared to live out your main character moments, since this year's theme is If We Were a Movie.
We wanted to give a shout out to our girls tennis team, who is currently having an undefeated season. Keep it up, girls tennis.
And we also wanted to commend Lowell Latinos Unidos for hosting the Hispanic Heritage Assembly. Follow their social media to keep being updated on events like those.
In honor of the very first episode of this school year, we wanted to pay homage to the creators of Video Lowell.
They did not die, but they went to college. Anyways, do you sing in the shower?
I don't. What would I sing?
Never thought about that. Let's go find out.
Your hosts, Charlotte and Yenna here.
And today we're asking people what their favorite song is to sing in the shower. Please tell us your name.
I'm Elizabeth.
I'm Rachel.
What is your favorite song to sing in the shower?
Mine is Clarity by Zedd.
Probably Red by Taylor Swift.
We're gonna get a lot of those today.
Okay. Please tell us your name.
Parker.
Harry.
What is your favorite song to sing in the shower?
0 to 100 by Drake.
Okay.
What's yours?
I like the song Seek Jah by Egyptian.
Okay.
What are your names?
Alex. Sullivan.
And what are your guys' favorite songs to sing in the shower?
Don't Stop Me Now by Queen.
Stuck in the Middle with You.
Bye. Yay, thank you. What are both of your names?
Both of my names.
My name is Mr. Chu.
I'm Dylan.
And what is your favorite song to sing in the shower?
I think it's probably something from the 80s. I was thinking Heaven is a Place on Earth. Belinda Carlisle.
Sex Sounds by Lil TJ.
Thank you! What are your guys' names?
I'm Brandon.
Maddie.
And what's your guys' favorite song to sing in the shower?
Mine is Boyfriend by Big Time.
I love that song!
Baby by Justin Bieber.
Alright, what are you guys' names?
Micah.
Sophia.
What is your favorite song to sing in the shower?
I had it and then I lost it.
Sorry, I just don't know.
What's your favorite song?
Forget You by CeeLo Green.
That's a good song. Actually, I sing You by CeeLo Green.
What is your name?
Mr. Frazier.
And what is your favorite song to sing in the shower?
My favorite song to sing in the shower is You Should Have Put a Ring.
Thank you very much. If you want to give these songs a better listen, scan the QR code or look at the link in our Instagram.
Next up, we have Lucas and his cold-blooded guests.
Yenna, how do you feel about reptiles?
Personally, I am not the biggest fan, but do you know who has the worst phobia?
Wait, who?
Snit.
Wait, didn't we assign Snit to the reptiles segment?
Huh. I did not think about that one. Yeah, we did. Let's go see how this one turned out.
Hi, I'm Snit.
And I'm Nick.
And this is Lucas, and he's going to go ahead and introduce himself.
Hello, I am Lucas. I am co-president of the Eco Club, and I host unofficial meetings where we get to hang out with some reptiles at Ralph Nichols Park every once in a while.
Today, Snit will be blindfolded, and she's going to have to guess what animal is being placed on top of her. Snit, how do you feel?
Excited.
Let's get to it.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.
Alright, let's get started with creature number one.
Oh my god.
Oh. Oh, it's moving. Yeah.
This is from Australia.
Uh-huh.
It is pretty spiky, and some people might say it has a beard.
Is it like a lizard?
It is a lizard, yeah.
Can I open my eyes?
This is
this is cute!
Bearded dragon, which is from Australia. They have sort of a scaly beard that will puff out when they're intimidated, and that's where the name comes from.
Very nice. Can we get this taken off of me, please? Oh, right. It's stuck to my sweater.
Thank you, Lucas. And great job dealing with that bearded dragon.
It's actually really scary when your eyes are closed and you have no idea what's, you know, being put, what's touching you.
This is going to be our second creature of the day. And Snit will be trying to feel it and touch it and see what it is. Alright, the thing that is right in front of you.
Actually feels really nice. Is it a tortoise?
Oh yeah, so this is a African spur-thighed tortoise. They do get quite large, they're the third largest species in the world that isn't extinct at this point.
These guys, as you might guess, are from Africa. And they get their name from these two spurs underneath the bottom of their shell under their head, and they'll ram into things really hard if they don't like them, such as rocks that look like tortoises and lions occasionally.
Thank you. That's a very cool tortoise. What do you think of that animal?
I think it's cool. I like how it's like kind of hard on top. Feels nice.
All right. Good job with creature number two, Snit. All right, guys. So this is going to be our third and final creature of the day. But what Snit doesn't know is that this creature is going to be a snake. And she is very afraid of snakes. So hopefully she won't freak out super bad or anything. How are you feeling, Snit?
Not too well right now. I just heard Lucas unbuckle the thing, and woo! Just, don't really just, know if I want to do this.
Just keep your arms
wait,
out.
Wait. Oh my. Right. Oh, yeah, no.
So do you have any guesses what this might be?
Yep. Is that a snake?
Oh yeah, so this is not just any snake. This is a carpet python from Northern Australia. And they're called carpet pythons because their pattern is said to mimic, or not mimic, but it looks a lot like the Aboriginal people's carpets that they would make. And she is a very sweet girl. She looks pretty scary, as you can probably tell. But I promise she's really nice. She's never bitten anyone. She's never done anything.
Oh, okay.
And I probably should help Snit now, so I'm going to give this back.
I don't like this.
Thank you, Snit. You did a very good job today. And that will conclude us for Snit Takes on Snakes. Thank you, Video Lowell.
I don't like that. Have
oh my god, glad that wasn't us.
Follow these accounts on Instagram for more updates.
We all have secrets. Did you know that Yenna snuck out the car before she had her license?
Charlotte, you were not supposed to say that. Anyways, the Video Lowell team did a bit of investigation. Let's go see what we found out.
Oh hey, my name is Tegan.
I'm Kiera.
And I'm Brooke.
We're a nosy bunch.
And we wanted to learn more about our fellow Lowell students.
Today we'll be asking them their biggest, darkest, top secret.
Tell us a deep secret that you have.
Oh no! Alright! In third grade, she had a boyfriend. And I got with your boyfriend. I never told you that.
You're such a liar.
No, I'm not joking. But yeah. No, I'm being serious. I'm sorry.
I can't pronounce the full name of one of my closest friends. And it's been a while.
Last weekend, I was out at a party. And I actually kissed an upperclassman, which was a little bit awkward.
I failed French 3 times.
I hid a lot of my tutoring homework under furniture for several years.
I run a Mr. Foray fan page on Instagram.
I have friends.
The first time I ever drove was my friend's car.
and I was a freshman and I almost crashed it.
That I drove a really far distance without my mom knowing.
When I was 5, I think I killed a dog. I thought it was okay to like feed dogs like chocolate, and I was like trying to teach the dog tricks.
The first strike was right at my balls, and I don't know why. And after that, like the week or two after, my legs were just wobbly after that. I could not walk straight. My parents, when they asked, yeah, I just banged up my knee while running.
I do chugger.
I change my outfits when I come to school.
They got a tattoo. Secret. Oh, this happened yesterday. My Spanish teacher, he wanted to take my phone away, and I had one of his ink pads. So I put it in the pouch, and I gave it to him, so I don't think he realized.
Lowell does not support or condone any illegal activity.
And remember that these secrets may or may not be true, but always remember that some things are better left unsaid. Next up, we have our very own global ed leader, aka Dr. Jones.
Good morning, this is Dr. Jones, your proud principal at Lowell High School. I hope everyone's doing well. I just have a few announcements that I'd like to make this morning. Follow me on the principal's IG page at Global Ed Leader, GLOBALED Leader, so that you can see the school through the eyes of the principal. The principal's weekly update comes out every Friday, so you should be receiving an email along with your parents regarding any updates for the next school week. That comes out on Friday, so please look out for that. If you have any announcements that you'd like to include, take a look at the bottom link and put those in there so that we can include any updates that you'd like the school community to know. Safety, safety, safety is first. Everyone is required or asked to wear their ID badges. You should have gotten one of these from Life Touch. There's another portrait session coming up in December. Please wear your ID badges. Please make sure you attend registry. There is attendance that's taken during that class, very important. Tomorrow is our first Joy Wagon Wednesday, where I will come around and spread some joy with a few treats that you can take part in. Please make sure that you are able to say hello to me, grab a treat, and maybe we'll even get some photos and video footage for the principal's IG page. Football and girls volleyball. Thank you all for welcoming me this past Friday to the game. It was great to see everyone in action, as well as congratulations to the coaches for a great start of the season. Thank you also. In my instructional rounds yesterday, I was able to be serenaded by the chorus there in the chorus room. So thank you all. Go on my IG page, the principal's page, and see and hear actually this amazing chorus. Thank you also to the Cardinal Robotics for adding me, following me on IG and allowing me to follow you this morning during my rounds. That's all I have for today. I hope all is well with you and your family and loved ones. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time.
That concludes our very first episode of Video Lowell for the 2022 to 2023 school year.
Thank you so much for watching, and make sure you follow at Video Lowell on Instagram and let us know what you thought.
Make sure to also subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is also at Video Lowell. See you guys next month.
Yenna and Charlotte out.